Suppose we write here, suppose this is a matrix 1, 0, 0, then 0, 1, 0, and 0, 1, 0. So here all the entries on the principal diagonal, that is 1, 1, 2, all entries. This is the principal diagonal, and the entries other than principal diagonals all are zero. So this matrix is called a diagonal matrix. Next, so scalar matrix. So what is meant by scalar matrix? Scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix in which all the diagonal entries should be same. And identity matrix is a scalar matrix. So identity matrix, first of all, it is a square matrix. Second, it's a diagonal matrix and scalar matrix in which all the entries on the principal diagonal are one. So we'll see some examples of a diagonal matrix. Here, this is a diagonal matrix because here the entries, this is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and this is the principal diagonal. So the elements other than the principal diagonals are all 0. The elements on the principal diagonals may be 0, may not be 0, but the condition is that the principal, which the elements which are not lying on the principal diagonals, all should be 0. Here, scalar matrix is again a diagonal matrix. So the elements which are not lying on the principal diagonal, that is here, 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 all should be 0. And the elements which are all lying on the principal diagonals, all the elements should be same. So here is 3, here is 3, here is 3. So this is a scalar matrix, this is a diagonal matrix. And the identity matrix is a scalar matrix again. And the condition is that the elements which are lying on the principal diagonal all should be 1. So here 1, 1, 1. So this is the identity matrix. And here the number of rows are 3 and number of columns are 3. So the order of this matrix is 3 cross 3. Or we denote the identity matrix by capital letter I. Next type, null matrix or a zero matrix. A matrix whose all elements are zero is called a null matrix. It is not necessary that a null matrix or a zero matrix is also always square. Null matrix may be square matrix, may not be a square matrix. Upper triangular matrix. Upper triangular matrix is a square matrix in which the elements which are lying below the principal diagonal all should be zero. And lower triangular matrix, it means the elements which are lying above the principal diagonals all are zero. I will repeat, upper triangular matrix. So upper triangular matrix means the elements. Here this is an example of upper triangular matrix. This is the principal diagonal. The elements which are lie on the principal diagonals are 1, 2, 3. The elements 1, 2, 3. So this is the principal diagonal, and the elements which are lying below the principal diagonal, this is this and this. This all are 0. So this is the upper triangular matrix. Next, for the lower triangular matrix, the elements which are lying, this is a principal diagonal, 1, 2, 3, so this is the principal diagonal. The element which are lying above the principal diagonal, this element, this element, this element. So all these three elements are zero. So this matrix is called a lower triangular matrix. Is it clear, all the types?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, yes, all clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, what if we take the diagonal from the right corner, like 0, 0, 1?
Yeah.
What if we take the diagonal?
So this is not a principal diagonal, actually. So the diagonal which is from the left to right. So this is the principal diagonal. In the matrix, this diagonal is called a principal diagonal from left to right. Okay. Next, so equality of a matrix. Suppose there are two matrix A and B. Here, the two matrix A and B are said to be equal. First, the order of both the matrix should be same. That is, if the order of A is 3 cross 2, then the order of B should be 3 by 2. So first, equality of two matrix, the first necessary condition is the order of two matrix should be equal. And second, each element of A is same as the corresponding element of B. So here one example, here the matrix whose elements are 1, 2, 0, 1. And here is another matrix, 1, 2, 0, 1. First of all, this is a 2 by 2 matrix. This is again a 2 by 2 matrix. So order of these two matrix equal. And one here, one is the first element of the matrix. Here is again, one is the first element. 2 is the second element, here 2 is the second element, here 0 is the first element of the second row, here is again 0 is the first element of the second row, here 1 is the second element of second row, and here 1 is the second element of second row. That is, suppose this is matrix A and this is matrix B, order of the both the matrix is same, and the corresponding elements are again same. Here 1 is equals to 1, 2 is equals to 2, 0 is equals to 0, and 1 equals to 1. So these two matrix are equal. Next here, tell me why two matrices are not equal. This is matrix and this is again matrix. These two matrices are not equal. Why?
Because each element is not equal to the corresponding element.
So 0 is not equal to 1.
Yeah. In the second row, first column, that is A, 2, 1. Here A, 2, 1 is 0. And suppose this is matrix B. Here B, 2, 1 is 1. So here 0 is not equals to 1. So that's why these two matrices are not equal. Here we will see one example here. This is one matrix and this is another matrix, and we are given that these two matrices are equal. So when we say that the two matrices are equal,
all the elements are same.
Yeah, corresponding elements.
Corresponding angles are elements are equal.
Yeah. A plus B is equals to 6. So a plus b is equals to 6 and 2 is equals to 2, 5 is equals to 5, and a into b is equals to 8. So solve this and tell me the answer. Is this correct? A is equals to 2 and b is equals to 4. So first here ab is equals to 8. So we can write b is equals to 8 upon a. Then we substitute here.
It will give a quadratic equation, ma'am. There will be two answers. Maybe a equal to 2 or a is equal to 4 and b equal to 4 or b equal to 2.
Yeah, so similarly, two answers. A is equals to 2, b is equals to 4 or vice versa. A is equals to 2 and a is equals to 4. Good, Aditya. Okay, next.
I have one doubt, ma'am.
Yes.
मैम अगर ए और बी की दो वैल्यूज आती है तो फिर हमको कौन सी दो वैल्यूज लेनी है?
अब देखो अगर हमने ए एंड बी की ए इक्वल्स टू 2 बी इक्वल्स टू 4 अगर सब्स्टिट्यूट किया तो देखो यहाँ पे क्या मिल जाएगा, सेम ए प्लस बी 6 आएगा, ए इंटू बी 8 आएगा, राइट? एंड अगर हमने बी इक्वल्स टू 2 एंड ए इक्वल्स टू मतलब वाइस वर्सा किया तो सेम ही आंसर आएगा ना, तो दोनों भी चलेगा, नो प्रॉब्लम. ठीक है, कोई चेंज? देखो ए प्लस बी इज 6 and a into b, their product is 8. So both the answer are correct. A is equals to 2, b is equals to 4, or a is equals to 4, b is equals to 2. Clear, Rahul?
Yes, ma'am.
Next. Now, this is a question. Yeah. Here, these two matrices are same, right? So, tell me what will be the first. X plus 3 is equals to 0. So, what will be X?
Minus 3.
X minus 3, yes. So, Z plus 4 is equals to 6. So, the value of Z will be?
2.
2y minus 7 is equals to 3y minus 2. So, Y will be?
Minus five.
Next, 4x.
Yeah.
So we get the value of x, right? A minus 1 is equal to minus 3.
Minus 5.
So
a is equal to?
Minus 2.
Minus 7.
C is minus 1.
Yes.
Correct. Minus 2. Next, 0 is equals to 2c plus b. So here we get one equation, linear equation with two variables. Next, b minus 3 is equals to 2b plus 4. So from here we can find out the value of b, right?
B is minus 7.
Minus 7.
So b is equals to, from here we get b is equals to? B is equals to what? Minus 7. So what will be C? What will be the value of C?
Minus 7.
Minus 7. So the value of C is?
Minus one.
Yes. Yeah. And what was Z? The value of Z is? If we equate these two, so Z plus 2C is equals to 0. So what will be C?
Minus one.
And if we equate these two, then we get C is?
Seven.
See, ek value mil rahi hai ya do different values mil rahi hai, batao. Do equations hai, two C. Different values hai na? Ya same hai?
Different hai.
डिफरेंट है तो ये इसकी ये इक्वेशन सेटिस्फाई कर रहा है क्या? No. Okay. So question number 2 is, if 2a plus 1 is equals to a plus 3, phi a is equals to 10, 0 is equals to 0, and b square plus 1 is equals to 26. So find the value of, yes?
Good morning. After this explain short, as a information.
My answer is 7.
So here, these are the answers. X plus 3 is equal to 0, so we get x is equal to minus 3. Z plus 4 is equal to 6, so we get z is equal to 2. 2y minus 7 is equal to 3y minus 2, so we get y is equal to minus 5. A minus 1 is equal to minus 3, so a is equal to minus 2. 0 is equal to 2, c plus 2 actually. Here, there is one correction. This is 2c plus 2, not b. Make a correction. This is not b, this is 2. Okay? So, you get c is equal to. C is equals to?
Minus.
Yeah. And so similarly, we can find out the other values. So here, question number 2. 2a plus 1 is equals to a plus 3. So a is equals to?
2.
Here we get a is equals to 2. Next, 5. B square plus 1 is equals to 26. So we get two different values for b, right? So
b is equals to minus five.
So these both the values for b satisfy the equation. If we substitute b is equals to 5 or b is equals to minus 5. So what will be a plus b?
A plus b is equals to 7 or
7 or
7 and minus, or,
minus 3. A plus b will be 7 or a plus b will be minus 3. Correct. So what is the necessary condition for the equality of two matrix?
All the corresponding elements of the matrix.
Corresponding elements.
The order should be equal and the corresponding elements should be.
Yeah, correct Tanya. Order pehle to order same chahiye, uske baad corresponding elements same chahiye. Agar order hi equal nahi hai, तो आगे हम जा ही नहीं सकते ना, बाद में देखना ही नहीं है कि करस्पॉन्डिंग एलिमेंट्स इक्वल है या नहीं, राइट?
यस सर।
नेक्स्ट ऑपरेशन ऑन अ मैट्रिसेस, सो देयर आर फ्यू ऑपरेशंस दैट इज एडिशन ऑफ टू मैट्रिसेस, डिफरेंस ऑफ टू मैट्रिसेस, स्केलर मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ टू मैट्रिसेस। सो फर्स्ट वी विल सी द एडिशन ऑफ टू मैट्रिसेस। सो सपोज देयर आर टू मैट्रिक्स A and B, और हमें add करना है, same corresponding elements add करना है हमें, तो मुझे बताओ important क्या होगा, अगर हमें corresponding elements add करने है matrices के, तो कैसे add करें, अगर suppose A is matrix, write down any matrix, A whose order is 3 by 3, write down any matrix whose order is 3 by 3, write down the identity matrix, identity matrix of order 3 by 3, and another matrix, same identity matrix of order 4 by 4. Aur condition ye hai ki corresponding elements add karne hai. To add kar sakte ho corresponding elements?
Nahi.
No.
Agar A11 hai, to A11 add with A11. A12, right? लेकिन जो इन द सेकेंड मैट्रिक्स है, द सेकेंड आइडेंटिटी मैट्रिक्स है, उसमें एक एलिमेंट एक्स्ट्रा होगा ना, फोर्थ कॉलम, ठीक है, तो ये यहाँ पे तो 3 कॉलम्स है और यहाँ पे 4 कॉलम्स है, सो वी कैन नॉट ऐड टू मैट्रिसेस, सो फॉर द एडिशन द नेसेसरी कंडीशन इज सेम, द ऑर्डर ऑफ टू मैट्रिक्स शुड बी इक्वल ऑर्डर सेम होनी चाहिए दोनों की या और उसके बाद क्या करना है देन वी विल एडिंग द करस्पॉन्डिंग एलिमेंट्स ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स सो हियर ए इज अ मैट्रिक्स हुज ऑर्डर इज एम क्रॉस एन देखो अगर मैट्रिक्स स्क्वायर होना जरूर नहीं है इट मे बी स्क्वायर मे नॉट बी स्क्वायर सो ए इज अ मैट्रिक्स एंड बी इज अ मैट्रिक्स So here the order of A is m cross n and the order of B is again m cross n. So order of two matrices are same. Then we can add the matrix. So we get again one new matrix whose elements are Aij plus Bij. That is we adding the corresponding elements of A with the element of B. So here is the note. The sum of two matrices is defined only when they are of the same order. Here the matrix A and matrix B. Now tell me what is the order of matrix A?
2 into 3.
The number of rows are 2 and the 2 by 3. And the number of columns are 3. So order of matrix A is 2 by 3 and the order of matrix is
2 by 3.
So we can add these two matrices. So addition A plus B will be the adding corresponding elements. So 1
plus 7.
Yeah, 1 plus 7, then 2 plus 8, 3 plus 9, 4 plus 1, 5 plus 2, and 6 plus 3. So here we get the resulting matrix that is 8, 10, 12, 5, 7, 9. And here, what is the order of resulting matrix?
2 by 3.
Same 2 by 3. So if we add two matrices, we get a new matrix with the same order. Here the matrix A and matrix B. The order of matrix A is 2 by 3. And the order of matrix B is
3 by 2.
So we cannot 3 by 2. Yeah, 3 by 2. So we cannot add these two matrices as the order of these two matrices is different. There are some properties for order of a matrix. First is the commutative property. What is commutative property for the natural numbers or for the real numbers? Commutative property for the real numbers. 2 plus 3 is equals to? 2 plus 3. The sum, what is sum of 2 and 3?
5.
And 3 and 2?
5.
Again, 5. That is 2 plus 3. 2 plus 3. In the real numbers, the 2 plus 3. 2 plus 3 is same as 3 plus 2. So, same. So, the commutativity, this is called the commutative law, right? So, the commutative property again hold for the matrix that is the A plus B is same as B plus A. मतलब अगर हमने order change किया addition में, तो जो result and answer होगा, that will be same. Next, associativity. That is A plus B plus C is same as A plus B plus C. If we add first two matrices A and B, then add C. This is same as first adding A, B and C, then adding A. Existence of identity. Tell me what is the identity element for the real numbers in the real number additive identity for the real numbers matlab agar koi sa bhi element usme agar humne ek aisa real number add kiya to wo as it is rahega suppose a is real number a plus what is equals to a
minus a
a plus minus a is a
0 0 0 0
is the yes 0 is the additive identity in the real numbers and here the null matrix that is the zero matrix is the additive identity for the matrix addition so that is A plus O is equals to O plus A here O is the null matrix or zero matrix and their sum is again A only next existence of inverse additive inverse that is suppose A is real number Then if we add minus a to a, so what will be the answer? A plus of minus a? A plus of minus a?
Zero.
So for every matrix, A is a matrix, there exists a matrix minus a, such that their sum is a null matrix. And next is the cancellation law. That is A plus B is equals to A plus A. So we can cancel A from the both side. So we get B is equals to C. Ye kaise ho sakta hai batao? A plus B is equals to A plus C. So how will get B is equals to C? Iska proof chahiye mujhe proof. If A plus B is equals to B plus C implies B is equals to C. This is correct. Tell me proof of this. Here.
A cancel ho jayega na.
A plus B is equals to A plus C. ये कैसे cancel होगा Tania? A को कैसे cancel कर सकते हैं? A plus B is equals to A plus C. कैसे cancel करें? Directly cancel कर सकते हैं क्या?
नहीं पता नहीं.
So if we add both the side, here हमने यहाँ पे क्या देखा? Existence of universe. For every matrix A,
minus A.
Minus A. So here we can add minus A. And here also we can add minus A. So if we add both the side minus A plus A, so this is zero. Minus A plus A, this is zero, and minus A plus A, this is zero. And what is zero? Zero plus B? Zero plus B will be? Zero means the null matrix. Minus A plus A, we get the null matrix. And here minus A plus A, we get the null matrix. So here we left with B, and here we left with C. So we get B is equals to C. Similarly, this is this law is called the left cancellation law. Here we cancel A from the left hand side. And next is the right cancellation law, because B plus A is equals to C plus A. Abhi yaha pe A kya hai? Right side mein. And here we cancel out A from the right hand side. So this is called a cancellation law. Right cancellation laws and left cancellation laws. Next.
Ma'am, I doubt ma'am.
Aap poochho.
मैम ये कैंसलेशन लॉ नहीं समझे, एक बार समझा दो ना.
हाँ हाँ एक मिनट. देखो राहुल, यहाँ पे वी स्टार्ट विद ए प्लस बी इज इक्वल्स टू ए प्लस सी, राइट? दिस इज गिवन टू अस. नेक्स्ट हम क्या कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे, जो देखो हमें अभी ऊपर देखा कि फॉर एवरी मैट्रिक्स ए देयर एग्जिस्ट माइनस ए, राइट? मतलब माइनस से कैसे मिलेगा? माइनस वन से. अगर हमने अगर यहाँ पे कोई मैट्रिक्स है वन 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 वन, तो माइनस से क्या होगा बताओ मुझे? व्हाट विल बी माइनस से?
सॉरी,
इफ अ मैट्रिक्स ए हुज ऑर्डर इज टू बाय टू मैट्रिक्स है और उसके एलिमेंट से सपोज वन 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 वन, देन व्हाट विल बी माइनस से?
माइनस वन
माइनस वन माइनस वन माइनस वन माइनस वन. और ए प्लस ऑफ माइनस से क्या होता है? नल मैट्रिक्स. सो हियर वी एड minus a both the sides. ठीक है, तो ये देखो minus a plus k क्या हो जाएगा, ये in the left hand side minus a plus a will be null matrix. Null matrix, right? And null matrix plus b is again b by the third law, existence of identity, right? And here again say minus a plus a will be null matrix.
Yes.
And null matrix plus c is
C.
So we get B is equals to C.
C.
हाँ, अब देखो यहाँ पे मिला हमें implies B is equals to C.
C.
So अब यहाँ पे जो A हमने cancel out किया, ये कहाँ पे? Left hand side पे. Here A is on the left hand side, right? So this law is called the left cancellation law. And here A is on the right hand side. So similarly, we will adding minus A to the right hand side. So minus A plus A will be null matrix. So in the LHS we left with B, and in the RHS we left with C. So this is called the right cancellation. Understood?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Next, scalar multiplication. What do you mean by scalar multiplication? Suppose A is a matrix of any order. It may be square matrix, may not be square matrix. Here A is a matrix of any order, and K is any real number. KB any